And so, dear ones, you are this higher self. It is your limited definition of your own being in your mind that continues to advance, continues to forward, continues to fuel the thoughts to occur within your head. Can you understand this? As long as you hold a mental construct of yourself, you will still be limiting the experience of that which you are. The truth, dear ones, is that you are all things. You are all experiences. You are every belief and every action. If not in this lifetime, in previous lifetimes, you have taken on the role of all possible human experience. You, dear ones, have been a sinner. You have been a saint. You have been a murderer. You have been a healer. You, dear ones, have been a warrior. You have been a doctor. You, dear ones, have been a celibate. You have been a lover. You, dear ones, have been a monk and a politician. You, dear ones, have fulfilled every role upon this earth. You have performed every possible action, so there is no need for judgment. Yes, dear ones, some experiences are more intense. Some experiences can be called less joyful. But, dear ones, they are necessary for this human experience. For we cannot appreciate the greatness of love until we experience the depth of fear, the depth of being alone in our own self-created experience. Fear, dear ones, is that of death, but it is not the real death that you will experience when leaving this earth. The real death does not bring you into a state of separation, but rather a greater state of unity. But, dear ones, the unity after death is experiencing itself here and now if you open yourself to it. For all that exists is possible here and now. You need not give up a physical body to ascend to the greatness of you. There were teachings, dear one, that ascension occurs after you drop the physical form. But we are telling you that ascension is being made here and now, by you, in this body, and in this world. The fear of death, dear ones, is that of being alone for eternity. And this fear, dear ones, is simply an idea. It is not reality. It's not the truth. For you can look all around you, and you can see that you have never been alone at all in this life. You can understand that which is creating you, the consciousness of life, exists everywhere and always has. You can understand that you are such an impossible miracle that there must be something wiser, something greater than that which you already know. There is evidence, dear one, that shows that nearly all of human beliefs are flawed. There is evidence. You just simply need to look. But the looking for mental evidence is not necessary when you find this truth within your heart. So go there. Bypass the maze of your mind. You do not need to solve every mental problem. You do not need to fix every mental question. Instead, dear ones, you can simply be, and you can experience the answer in every moment, the answer that you have always been seeking. It is the state of oneness, in which you no longer feel separate from anything and anyone, in which you no longer feel separate from the love of God. It is the experience of being completely accepted as you are. But you, dear ones, you must begin with you. You must make this journey more fully into yourself. You must accept, honor, and love all parts of you. You must love, dear one, the hideousness that you sometimes see in the mirror, the hideousness that you sometimes see in yourself, for it is only your mind that has called it ugly, and in truth it is a beautiful creation of God. Yes, dear ones, all of you is loved by God. So give yourself this experience. Surrender into your heart, and allow the love to purify all of the false beliefs, all of the chaotic emotion, all of the restless body. Give yourself peace in every moment. Surrender, dear ones, is not the act of giving up. It is not the act of admitting defeat. Surrender, dear ones, is the act of letting go. It is the act of dropping our walls to allow ourselves to merge back in to the greater field of life. It is the act of letting go to allow ourselves to dive deeper into the love that exists right here and right now in every moment. You, dear ones, are creative consciousness. You, dear ones, have control over how you are expressing yourself and over what you are perceiving. It is your gift. It is your role to live as an aspect of the Creator. So what will you create? What will you allow your expression to be? What will you choose to perceive in this moment? We are with you. We have always been with you. There is no separation, because it is only an idea in your mind and not in the mind of God. Many blessings, dear ones. Much love and namaste.